look at the this thing materials as such. So we have non-resorbable sutures and we have resorbable sutures. Okay, so the important thing about sutures is, first and foremost, the diameter of the suture, the thickness of the suture. So thickness of the suture varies from 10 to 110. As the number of zeros increase, basically the thickness is decreasing. In dentistry, generally we end up using two different thickness of sutures: 30 for full thickness flaps, 50 for partial thickness flaps. Okay, now once we have understood the thickness part, the next important thing is cross section. So always and always, the needle which you are supposed to use is supposed to be of reverse cutting cross section. We have to understand that there are three basic types of needles which are used in surgery. One is cutting needle. Cutting needle means, instead of this reverse triangle, the cutting edge would have faced on the inside of the reverse needle, of the curved needle. So that cutting needle would be used where? In skin suturing. Then we have round bodied needles, needles which are round bodied in cross section. Those would be used in muscle suturing. And in mucosal suturing, we are supposed to use reverse cutting. This is one thing that we are supposed to remember. Another thing is, this is a suage suture material. Suage suture material means that the needle is not supposed to be eyed. I'll just demonstrate also after opening up one. The outer packet is non-sterile, so we can touch it. And the inner packet is supposed to be sterile. We are supposed to just put it then on the surgical tray. So once we have removed this particular suture, are you able to see? The suture thread is attached to the needle. So how is it attached? Is it attached by a glue sort of a thing? No. This is swaged. The meaning of the word swaged is that the end of the needle is hollow. At the time of manufacturing of the suture material itself, the suture material was put inside this thing and it was crushed. It was compressed. And that is how the suture is attached. So this is known as what? Atraumatic needle. Atraumatic needle means, once I'll be passing it through the tissues, basically the size of the wound that would be formed would be narrower. This is different from a traumatic needle, also known as eyed needle. Eyed needle means it would have an eye here, and once that eye is there, I would have passed my suture material like this. I would have tied a knot. So the entire needle was narrow, the end was broad. Couple it up with a knot which has been tied, it becomes even more broad. So ultimately what happens is, once I am passing it through the tissues, the wound which is formed, the suture wound, that is huge. Hence it is traumatic. Okay? So always and always we have to use ideally atraumatic needle, and that atraumatic needle is what? Swage needle. Okay? At the same time, the next this thing is 3x8 circle. 3x8 circle means it is slightly less than half a circle. So what does that mean? That had I been stitching a button in a shirt, I would have used a straight needle. Now the problem of using a straight needle in a confined space like the oral cavity is that that needle would have gone ahead and penetrated the tissue on the opposite side. So we need a curved needle, and studies have shown that 3x8 curvature, that is less than half. 4x8 would have been half circle. This is 3x8 circle, less than half. The curvature is such that it is easiest to penetrate and retrieve even in the posterior area. Okay, so this much about the needle. Is it fine? And we have covered up two main types of this thing, thickness in resorbable, that is 30 and 50. 30 basically was for full thickness, 50 basically is for partial thickness, right? We have different types available. For example, 40 generally is ideal, sort of a compromise between 30 and 50, meaning 40 you would be able to use in partial thickness also, and 40 you would be able to use in full thickness also if it is 16 mm. So 16 mm needle is the sweet spot between the bigger needle required for posterior areas, 26 mm, and the smaller needle required basically for anterior or mucogeneral surgery, that is 12 mm. So instead of using 26 mm and 16 mm, we can easily use 16 mm. But this is the problem which I have been facing since my PG time. So during our PG time also, we used to try to get this 16 mm needle, a common needle in which I have done a flap surgery. I should be able to suture my horizontal incision also, and I should be able to suture my vertical incision also. But this was the problem which was there in majority of these needles. 16 mm usually comes in cutting cross section. So what does cutting cross section means? The triangle is facing on the upside, on the upper side. So this sort of a needle should be used where skin suturing, not to be used in mucosal suturing. It will tear through either at the time of suturing or maybe in the 1 week post-operative period where that suture was given, for which that suture was given. So this is basically non-resorbable. In non-resorbable, sutures are basically, we say, divided into non-resorbable, resorbable, both divided into natural and synthetic. So this is basically a natural non-resorbable suture material, that is silk. Now the problem with silk is, firstly, advantage is it is cheap, easily available. Disadvantage is it is braided. For strength, lot of threads are twisted together. So because of that braided thing, ultimately what happens is something known as wicking effect. Wicking effect means once you take multiple ropes, thin ropes, and you twist them together to form a thick rope, micro spaces exist between those thin ropes. Through those micro spaces, microorganisms would be penetrating into the deeper portions of the wound. So this is one disadvantage of this particular material. It is braided. So wicking effect is there, strength is not there, color difference is there, but the advantage is cheap. That is why we are using. We have another suture material, proline. Now proline is a synthetic non-resorbable suture material. The strength is quite a bit. It is monofilament also, but it comes with two disadvantages. Firstly, proline is expensive as compared to silk. Secondly, proline is a very, very sharp suture material, rigid suture material. If you were to give it in the oral cavity, majority of the times the problem which personally I have faced with proline is it tends to tear through the tissues. Not just that, the ends of the suture, meaning you have given a suture with this and you have cut the knot, the ends of the suture, since this is a rigid suture material, are sharp enough and rigid enough to cause ulcers. So in our practice, what we used to do was we used to heat up the ball burnisher, and the ends of this thing, the thread knot which is formed by proline, we used to burn those ends. So once we used to burn those ends, the end which was supposed to be sharp used to become curved a little. But again, a suture material which I would not recommend as a dental surgeon, because it tears through, and whichever ends, strands are remaining, the patient will keep telling you, "Doc, the suture material is pinching in that area." Okay. So what we covered up right now was non-resorbable. So in non-resorbable, we covered up what? We covered up natural and synthetic. And we covered up few points which are common to both non-resorbable and resorbable. That is the basic specifications of the needle. We said the needle should be 26 mm, 3x8 reverse cutting, sewage dissector. That is something which we have been covering up. Okay. Now coming to resorbable. So resorbable suture materials again are divided into natural and synthetic. Now natural we don't have right now because we don't use that routinely, but we used to use it a lot during our PG time, 2002 to 2005. The resorbable material which was easily available in the market was chromic gut. You must have heard of cat gut. It is chromic gut. So chromic gut basically was a material which was got from the intestine of sheep, not cat. Okay, so intestine of sheep, we used to get that natural resorbable suture material. The problem with the cat gut or chromic gut was resorption. So the thing used to remain in the oral cavity for quite some time, but during the resorption process, basically a lot of inflammation used to be produced, because that was the problem with natural material. Resorption used to produce a lot of inflammation and patient used to develop a lot of erythema, lot of discomfort in the area of the sutures part. So this was one problem. Hence what has been done is we have shifted over now to synthetic resorbable suture materials. So the synthetic resorbable suture materials we use are PGA-PLA. PGA/PLA. That is copolymers of polyglycolic acid / polylactic acid. We use the term polyglactin 910 many a times. So 910 signifies that this material consists of 90% polyglycolic acid, 10% polylactic acid. Why is this combination present? Polyglycolic acid is a material which resorbs very fast. If you were to give a suture material which is of plain polyglycolic acid, the entire material will resorb within 4-5 days. is that much time sufficient for your wound healing to occur? Tensile strength won't be there. Even epithelial healing requires 7 days to get some amount of tensile strength. Connective tissue requires even more. So PGA was out just 4-5 days. Polylactic acid, L for lactic, L for long. So long resorption time was there of polylactic acid. So polylactic acid, pure implants or sutures would remain for months at end. So now what they did was they achieved this particular combination, 90% polyglycolic acid, 10% polylactic acid. And this was basically the advantage that ultimately ideal resorption time of roughly 16 to 20 days used to be there. This material, PGA, PLA, comes in two types. Here, of course, the two types are with regard to the difference in the specification also. 30 and 50. Can you see? Again, the two types. One is 26 mm. The other is 12 mm. So, one would be used for full thickness flaps. Another one would be used for partial thickness flaps. But basically, there's a difference in the color also. This is undyed Vicryl. This is dyed Vicryl. So, invariably, dyed Vicryl is a longer lasting suture material as compared to undyed Vicryl. So we'll just demonstrate. So ultimately, if I were to open up this particular material, this is again dyed Vicryl. So dyed Vicryl, if I were to open up, undyed Vicryl, I'm sorry. This is the color of undyed Vicryl. So ultimately a color, a neutral color, which actually merges with the color of the tissues. So as compared to silk, where straight away the black color would be sticking out. It would be very obvious, especially in the aesthetic areas, that where we have given sutures. Here, this color more or less merges with the tissues. This is dyed Vicryl, okay? As compared to undyed Vicryl. So, undyed Vicryl basically is, This is dyed Vicryl. So, dyed Vicryl, if you were to have a look, this is the smaller needle. This is purple in color. So are you able to see that purple color? So this is purple color, dyed, this is undyed. So this dyed Vicryl is the one which is more expensive, first and foremost. This lasts for a longer period of time. And ultimately, this is something which lasts for at least 25 to 30 days. So the next question is, do you require 25 to 30 days? Ideally don't require, because longer the suture is left behind, longer would be the, more would be the plaque accumulation around those sutures, and the healing time would be delayed as such. Are you getting a point? So according to me, from a financial point of view, economic feasibility point of view also, and from a biological point of view, this undyed Vicryl is fine. Okay. And finally, in resorbable, we have antibacterial coated suture material. Okay. The monocryl part is secondary. So monocryl, that is polyglycy capron, is another suture material which is resorbable, but the problem is resorption time is 90 to 120 days. So this is an issue. This is a big issue with this material. So many a times monocryl is actually suited for doing any surgery by a general surgeon inside the body, meaning let's say intestinal suturing was done, and they want that ultimately in the long run this material should resorb, but it should remain for a couple of months. So that ample strength is there that during peristaltic movement, the intestines should not be opening up. This material is suited more for those kinds of surgeries. Oral cavity, we can use it, but the resorption advantage would be lost, meaning nobody will leave sutures in the oral cavity for 90 days. In any case, we have to remove it. So what advantage is this thing offering? Is it the resorption time? No, it is not the resorption time. You don't require it for such a long period of time. The advantage is this is a triclosan coated suture material. Antibacterial coating is there. So the first thing which we tell after doing surgery is not to brush in that area. So once we have told not to brush in that area, if we have a suture which has an antibacterial coating, naturally plaque formation would be lesser. So this is a huge advantage. This again we are opening up. So from a demonstration point of view, so again all these suture materials will cost will be covered up from this thing part, the department fund part. So can you see a very very strong suture material, doesn't break that easily, and ultimately the strength is, why the strength is present, because the resorption time is more. So we need a better material. Okay. So all these materials, this is actually a monofilament suture material. these are supposed to be PGA PLA are supposed to be multi-filament braided suture materials. But what they have done is, after doing the braiding part, they have covered up the suture material with a layer of PGA. So inside it is braided, but outside a layer has been put to make it into a monofilament. So the advantage is, at least that wicking effect is not there. So I hope we were clear with regard to the types, and we have managed to see various types. We have silk, undyed vicryl, we have dyed vicryl, and we have antibacterial coated, triclosan coated, we have polyglycycapron suture also. So is it fine? So this much was about the demonstration of the materials. So in the next video, now we'll be starting about the demonstration of the techniques part.